Today we're going to replace the back brake pads on a 2008 Toyota RAV4. Today I'm going to replace the back brake pads on a 2008 RAV4. Okay. It looks like there's a couple of bolts we have to take off. Let's go get my tools and we'll see what happens. Okay, now that we've got the wheel off, I've been looking here, and what I can see is there's a 14 millimeter bolt here and another one here, so there's only two of them, and then this caliper piece will slide out. So I'm gonna take those off, take these two bolts off, and see what I get. All right, let's do that. We've got a 14 millimeter socket here. New cars are nice because all the bolts and stuff come off real easy. They're not all old and rusty or anything like that. So there's two bolts. Put those down. And here comes the caliper out. There you go. That piece is off. I'll set it right here. Or find a good spot for it. And here's our shoes, our pads. There's one. Not all the way down to metal yet. Here, let me turn the light on here. Get a better look at that. So that's this side. I'll put that down here. And slides out the back. There's another one. That one's worn pretty good. So, there you have it. Two screws and the pads are out. Now, putting it back together is not going to be too hard. There is one thing I have to do, and I'll show you that in a sec, is this right here. I need to put a C-clamp on it, and take this and squish it down very, very, very slowly, and it'll push brake fluid back up through here. And actually, brake fluid will fill up in the master cylinder, so you got to keep an eye on that. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a C-clamp on here, and I'm going to push this down real slowly, and before I can put the new pads in, because there's not enough room in here. I have to increase the space here. So that's pretty much the next step. So let me get a C-clamp and get that started. There's two ways you can do this. You can stick the C-clamp in the hole like that, or another good way to do it is to take the old one, stick it on there so it makes even pressure, and do it the opposite way. I'm going to choose to do it this way. There we go. And you just turn the C-clamp very slowly. Very slowly. It's going quite easily, quite nicely. So you can see this piston is going back into the caliper housing. Remember to go check the master cylinder level. Right now I barely put anything back in there, so it almost doesn't even need the C-clamp. I can almost push it my hand. Yes, it's going by hand, so there isn't a whole lot of frustration there. I don't want to get this rubber pinched when I put the new one in, so I'm trying to make sure that rubber's not on this face. Otherwise it'll pinch it and that'll not be good. Cool. So there you have it. A lot more space. And now it's all wide. So when it goes back on, it'll be fine. So I'll set this back here. And the next thing we need to do is get our new brake shoes out and prepare them for installation. These are Duralast Gold. These are equivalent to the EOM specifications as I was told at the shop, so I chose to go with the EOM specified pads. Let me show you the difference between the old and the new. There's a set of pads. I should really clean my fingers before I go and touch them. So I'm going to go wash my hands before I get more stuff on them. But there's a big difference if you look. They're pretty much, the old ones are pretty worn out. So let me go wash my hands and we'll take care of that. There are these little clips that need to go on there. What these little clips do is if you wear them down super, super far, this little metal piece will start to rub the rotor here and make a noise before you get metal to metal rubbing here and ruining the disc. And there's a little groove here that this needs to get popped into. So pop it in. There, it's popped into that groove. Make sure it's in place. Pop that guy in. Now that's in. Take the backside one out. Take another pin. Pop it on here. Make sure it's in that little groove. There's a little thing here that goes in that little groove. Now here, clip in. Turn it around. Get it back in there. Now, you have a safety device to protect your disc in the future, which these were just making noise. They weren't quite rubbing metal to metal or disc to indicator at yet, but I figured it was a good time to change them because of the number of miles on my car and it being all original. Okay, now two screws back on, or nuts, or bolts. Let's see, bolts. Pop those back on. This time I know what to do. I need the extra wrench. Turn this left. There we go. Okay, no extra parts laying around. Okay, there you go. That's the extent of putting new pads on the back. And I also did the front. It is the same thing, two bolts. Quite easy work to be done. You can take the rotor off and get it surfaced. I'm pretty happy with the surface of this, and I'm not going to do that at this time. It is recommended that it's done, but my experience is I get it done and then this just gets skinnier, and then I have to buy new ones before I think I need. If you have a pulsating brake pedal, get a new disc. Don't let that go. If your pedal or whatever is messed up, don't keep the disc. So in my case, I'm not doing any disc work. I'm just replacing the pads on the back of my vehicle. That gives you a good amount of information pretty quick on what it would take to go to the auto parts store, if you're running metal to metal, which if that indicator is hitting, if you're hearing a noise, you're probably not on, you know, on this metal to the disc, but so you've got a little bit of time to get your brakes done, but do it right away, and you saw how easy it was, so why wait? Okay, I'd like you to see the tools that I use for this project. A lug nut wrench, mine is collapsible. 2 14-millimeter, a ratchet, and a wrench. 14-millimeter. For one side, you'll need two brake pads, which you'll squish in like this. And don't forget the pins or indicators, so if this is all worn down, it'll start to rub the little indicator and make a noise so you know to replace your pads. And it won't get so far if you do it right away. You won't get rubbing metal to metal and cause you some more money getting new discs. So there's the tool, two of those. And I didn't really need the C-clamp to compress the caliper. It pretty much went by hand. And also remember to check the master cylinder under the hood there. Make sure that when you squish the caliper, the level's gonna go up. So make sure you have some room in there. Make sure it's not all the way at the top and you start doing that. And the floor jack for jacking the car up. So not a whole lot of tools here. Hope that information helps also. Here's the master cylinder. You can see that the brake level is here and the maximum is right here. So the maximum would be right there. So it's down and it looks like there's plenty of room for me to do the second brake pads on the other side. So it looks like when I'm done, this level should come up a little bit after I push in the caliper. So this is where you look to make sure that it doesn't fill up and overflow on you and you have to use like a turkey baster or something to remove some brake fluid that's needed sometimes. There you go. Now that the brakes are all installed, the calipers are pretty much all squished in, and now we have to make them come out and set to where they're going to be. So you don't want to just get in the car and start driving and think you're all set. We have the parking brake set on the car. I'm going to start the car and I'm going to just push the pedal lightly and easily to make the pistons go back out and push those pads against the disc. Well, here we go. And the pedal will be soft on the first foot. You can't see it, but I'm going to push slowly. And the pedal's just going down. I'm going to let it back up. I didn't go all the way to the floor either. I'm just going to give little kind of, you know, little pushes. Now I'm gonna do little, now I can feel the pedal getting hard and it's only moving, you know, the normal distance now. When I first started the car, the pedal could go a lot farther because it was pushing all the fluid back out there and setting everything right. So remember that step. Don't just jump in your car and think you're great, you know. You want that pedal to be hard and perfect at the right time. So, brakes feel good now on the pedal. I'm going to take it for a test ride. I think it should be fine. So, thanks for watching. Hope you got some good information out of this video. I'm not a professional mechanic. I'm actually a computer programmer by trade. I've been mechanically inclined my whole life. I'm 52 years old. I like working on things. I like fixing things myself. I like saving a couple dollars. I'm not a professional mechanic, so this is just my information. You do what you're going to do with the information, and I can't accept any liability for what you do from watching my video. So just hope it helps you maybe even understand what a mechanic goes through to do this job. It's really a rather simple job, and they will want to sell you other things like, you know, turning the discs, putting new rubber boots on, different things. You might need some of those things. So
And this is just the first job, so maybe not replacing the boots for me, maybe that's a good thing. Or, you know, it's an okay thing for me. But reading, if you read up on it, they suggest that you do a lot more work than I did. But that's my choice on how I repaired the back brakes, and whatever choice you make is your choice. Thank you.